Hello everyone again, welcome back to our online class. How are you doing? How are you doing? Are you doing fine? Are you doing great? So when I ask you how are you doing, it means how are you? How are you? Or how are you doing? If I ask you how are you, your answer is I am fine, I am good, I am great, I am fantastic. But when I ask you how are you doing, you have to answer, I am doing fine, I am doing good, I am doing great. But how are you and how are you doing, they are exactly the same. They have the same meanings. They want to ask you, are you fine or not? So how are you? I am fine. How are you doing? I am doing fine. So how are you doing? I hope you are doing fine, and I am doing fine too. And today I am so happy to be your teacher again. So today is Friday, right? And on every Friday, what textbook that we learn? The textbook that we learn on every Friday is this one, right? Listening Starter 2. So Listening Starter 2 is the book that we always learn on every Friday. And Friday is the last day of the week that we learn, right? So last week, what did you learn in this book? What did you learn on Friday last week? You learned about unit. What unit did you learn last week? Do you remember? So the unit that you learned last week is unit 2, right? Very good, unit 2. But what is the title of unit 2? So the title of unit 2 is My Family, right? Very good. So today we are going to continue this unit, this lesson. But before we go on, we have to review what you learned last week, right? So as you can see on the whiteboard here, these are some of the words, some of the vocabularies that you learned last week on Friday with your teacher. So can you read this word? Yeah, cousin, cousin, cousin. So what does it mean, cousin? So who is cousin? So cousin is the son or daughter of your uncle or aunt. And then this one, aunt, aunt. And how about this one? Uncle, uncle, uncle. So aunt is the sister of your dad, right? And uncle is the brother of your dad or your mom, okay? How about this one? Tall, 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 okay? So what does mean tall? When something is tall, it means it is high, right? Okay, if I am tall, it means I am very high, like 1.90 meters, okay? How about this one? Handsome, handsome. So handsome, we always use this adjective to describe about a boy or a man. If a boy or a man is handsome, he looks very good, he looks cool, handsome, and a lot of girls love to look at him, okay? Handsome. This one, thin, thin, thin. Can you repeat after me? Thin, thin, thin. So thin is the opposite word of the word fat, right? F-A-T. If you are thin, it means you look like me. Thin, it means that I am not fat, okay? So fat is the opposite word of the word thin. How about this word? Grandfather. Grandfather. So grandfather is your grandpa or your granddad. And this one? This word we can read in two ways. If you read in British, British English, you read pretty. Pretty, 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 okay? But if you read in American English, pretty, pretty. So letter T here, it sounds like letter D. Pretty, pretty. You are so pretty, 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 pretty. Can you repeat? Pretty, 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 okay? So British English, pretty, pretty. American English, pretty, 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 okay? Pretty is beautiful. How about this one? Kind, kind, kind. If you are kind, it means you are helpful, you like to help other people, okay? How about this one? Family. So in our family, we have father, we have mother, we have brother, sister, uncle, aunt, grandfather, grandmother, right? So these are the words, these are the vocabularies that you learned last week on Friday. So now let's go to the lesson that we've learned today. So here, unit 2, my family, we are still in unit 2, right? And it is on page what? Page 12. So if you open your book on page 12, you will see unit 2, my family. And section A, section B, you did it already last week, right? And also listening practice 1, you also did it last week already. So today we are going to Listening practice 2. Okay, so listening practice 2, there are two exercises, exercise A and exercise B. Exercise A, there are, I think, 1, 2, 3. There are 3 blanks that we have to complete, and there is 1 bracket that we have to choose the correct answer. And for section B, we have 3 questions, right? 1, 2, 3. And in each answer, I'm sorry, in each question, there are 3 answers, right? Like A, B, C, D, A, B, C, D, A, B, C, and D, right? So before you know the answer, so now let's go to section A. Listen and write notes. So a family party, Gabby is the name. So Mary's looks, Eddie is the name too. Mary's looks sad or cute. So before you can do all of this exercise, you have to listen. So now I will play the listening for you twice.
A. Listen and write notes.
Thanks for coming to the party, Carlos.
You're welcome, Maria.
We are getting ready to eat cake.
Who is the girl next to your grandmother? She looks happy.
That is my cousin Gabby. It is her birthday.
Who is the boy near Gabby? He looks cute.
That is my brother Eddie. He is 4 years old.
A. Listen and write notes.
Thanks for coming to the party, Carlos.
You're welcome, Maria.
We are getting ready to eat cake.
Who is the girl next to your grandmother? She looks happy.
That is my cousin Gabby. It is her birthday.
Who is the boy near Gabby? He looks cute.
That is my brother Eddie. He is 4 years old.
Okay, now you have finished listening to the listening already, right? So now let's check the answer. So who is Gabby? Who is Gabby? Who is Gabby? Mary's sister, Mary's brother, Mary's dad, Mary's mom, or who? So Gabby is Mary's cousin, right? Okay, so the first blank is, so Gabby is Mary's cousin. How about blank number 2? Gabby looks sad, looks cute, looks handsome, looks ugly, looks beautiful, looks happy, looks sad. So what is the answer? So Gabby looks happy. Okay, so now we have finished 2 blanks and we know who is Gabby. Gabby is Mary's cousin and Gabby looks happy. So now let's go to Eddie. Okay, we read Eddie. So there is one blank and there is also one answer in the bracket. So we have to choose the correct answer. So who is Eddie? Eddie is Maria's what? Maria. So what did you hear? Maria's, yeah, Maria's brother. Now we know that Eddie is Maria's brother and he looks sad or he looks cute. He looks, what did you hear? He looks cute, right? Okay, he looks cute, so we have to circle cute. Okay, so now we have finished exercise A, listen and write note. We know that Gabby is Maria's cousin. We know that Gabby looks happy. And we also know that Eddie is Maria's brother and Eddie looks cute. Now, let's go to section B. But before you can go to section B, you have to read the instruction. Like I told you, you have to read the instruction before you do the exercise. So listen again and answer the questions. Listen again and answer the questions. So here, there are 3 questions, right? Question number 1, question number 2, question number 3. So let's read first before we listen. Number 1, where are the speakers? Where are the speakers? Are they at school? Are they at a party? Are they at Carlos' house? Or are they on an airplane? Okay, so you have to listen and choose the correct answer. Number 2, who is Gabby? Mary's sister, Mary's aunt, Mary's cousin, or Mary's grandmother? And the last one, number 3, which is not true about Eddie? Which is not true, not true. Which is not true about Eddie? Okay, A, he looks cute. B, he is 4 years old. C, he is Mary's brother. And D, it's his birthday. So now, before you can get all the correct answers, you have to listen again. I will play the listening for you again twice. Twice means 2 times.
A. Listen and write notes.
Thanks for coming to the party, Carlos.
You're welcome, Maria.
We are getting ready to eat cake.
Who is the girl next to your grandmother? She looks happy.
That is my cousin, Gabby. It is her birthday.
Who is the boy near Gabby? He looks cute.
That is my brother, Eddie. He is 4 years old.
A. Listen and write notes.
Thanks for coming to the party, Carlos.
You're welcome, Maria.
We are getting ready to eat cake.
Who is the girl next to your grandmother? She looks happy.
That is my cousin, Gabby. It is her birthday.
Who is the boy near Gabby? He looks cute.
That is my brother, Eddie. He is 4 years old.
Okay, so now you have finished listening to the listening already. So now let's check the answer in section B. Let's start with number one. Where are the speakers? Are they at school? Are they at a party? Are they at Carlos' house? Or are they on an airplane? So the correct answer is B, right? They are at a party. That's why here, a family party, right? So you can get the answer from here. Let's go to number two. Who is Gabby? Is it Mary's sister, Mary's aunt, Mary's cousin, or Mary's grandmother? This is the answer, right? So Gabby is Mary's cousin. So the answer is C. Easy. So sometimes the first section can show you the answer into the next section. So you can take a look at it. And number three, which is not true? Not true about Eddie. He looks cute. He is 4 years old. He is Mary's brother. It's his birthday. So he looks cute. True, right? He is 4 years old. We don't know. He is Mary's brother. Correct too. So A and C is A and C are incorrect. We have to look at B and D. So he is 4 years old or it's his birthday. So today is Eddie's birthday or Gabby's birthday? So today is Gabby's birthday, right? So D, it's his birthday. It means it is not true about Eddie. So the correct answer is D. It's his birthday, but it is not his birthday because today is Gabby's birthday. Okay, so now we have finished listening practice 2, A and B. But before I end the video, I also have one expression for you. Take after. Take after. So what does it mean, take after? Have you ever heard about the expression take after? So what is it? So if you take after your dad, it means that your face looks like your dad's face. If you take after your mom, it means that your face looks like your mom. Okay, like for me, I always heard my relatives or my neighbors, they say that I take after my dad. It means that my face is the same to my dad's face. So it means that I take after my dad. Understand? So if you take after someone, you have similar appearance or the same face to that person. Okay, some children or most of the children, they always take after their parents. Okay, some kids, they take after their dads. Some kids, they take after their mom. But some kids, they take after both their dad, their moms. Okay, so I'm sure you know the word, the expression take after, right? When you take after someone, it means that you look the same as that person. Okay, so if I take after my mom, it means that my face looks like my mom's face. So that's called take after. So can I ask you, who do you take after? Do you take after your dad or do you take after your mom? Okay, so I don't know because I don't know your faces. Only you that can answer. So you can ask your parents, mommy or daddy, who do I take after? Do I take after you, mommy, or do I take after you, daddy? Okay, so you can ask them and you can tell me the answers in the comment below. Okay, so now we have finished, we nearly finished everything. So now let's go to the last action. The last action is I want to give you homework. So here, listening practice 1, you did it last week already. Listening practice 2, we have just finished it. How about listening practice 3? So listening practice 3 is your homework. So I want you to open your book on page 15 Open your book on page 15. Here you will see listening practice 3, exercise A and exercise B. Exercise A, listen and write the number next to the correct person. So there are a lot of people, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And then in the table, there are only 4 people. Jenny, Brian, Jeremy, and Brent's father. So you have to listen and you have to write the number. Okay, I will play the listening for you. And exercise B, listen again and choose T for true and F for false. Okay, T for true and F for false. So if that sentence is correct, you just call T, true. If that sentence is incorrect, you just call F, right? So very easy. So I will play the listening for you. So now that's the end of our video today. I hope that you will do your homework. I hope that you will review the lesson. Today is the last day of the week, right? So on Monday, we will see you again on Monday, right? So now I will play the listening for you. Goodbye.
A. Listen and write the number next to the correct person.
Your whole family is here today, Brian.
They all want to see me play soccer.
You really take after your father.
Do I, Jenny?
Yes. You both have brown hair, and your face looks like his.
I also look like my cousin over there. His name is Jeremy.
I don't think you look like your cousin. He looks so young.
Well, he is 8 years old, and I am 12, and he wears glasses. But we always look happy.
A. Listen and write the number next to the correct person.
Your whole family is here today, Brian.
They all want to see me play soccer.
You really take after your father.
Do I, Jenny?
Yes. You both have brown hair, and your face looks like his.
I also look like my cousin over there. His name is Jeremy.
I don't think you look like your cousin. He looks so young.
Well, he is 8 years old, and I am 12, and he wears glasses. But we always look happy.
A. Listen and write the number next to the correct person.
Your whole family is here today, Brian.
They all want to see me play soccer.
You really take after your father.
Do I, Jenny?
Yes. You both have brown hair, and your face looks like his.
I also look like my cousin over there. His name is Jeremy.
I don't think you look like your cousin. He looks so young.
Well, he is 8 years old, and I am 12, and he wears glasses. But we always look happy.
A. Listen and write the number next to the correct person.
Your whole family is here today, Brian.
They all want to see me play soccer.
You really take after your father.
Do I, Jenny?
Yes. You both have brown hair, and your face looks like his.
I also look like my cousin over there. His name is Jeremy.
I don't think you look like your cousin. He looks so young.
Well, he is 8 years old, and I am 12, and he wears glasses. But we always look happy.